Next drop is the miniature pony.
I'll just pass this little one out the window to you as I drive past, eh?
It should be the easiest, but Les has a problem.
The concern's the spot we got to drop it off. We can't get the semi into the property, which is quite normal, but there's not a hell of a lot of area to pull off. We sort of be right on the edge of a pretty busy road, getting the little guy out. Parked right on the fog line of the busy road, you don't want to be sitting there too long. We might end up with a car in the back with the horses.
Crossing roads with horses is asking for trouble.
I've had them even shy at the white line, you know, in the middle of the road. And all of a sudden, you stand there in the middle of a bloody road and the horse won't lead across the white line, traffic coming.
When Les gets to his drop-off spot, it's worse than he imagined.
Yeah, just got to pull up on the edge of the road here, man. We're on a bend. We're not in the best spot here. Certainly nowhere else to go here. We've got to get this little lockie out the back here and the traffic won't stop here. Breaking the traffic just to get out of the truck. Pretty ordinary strike, a blind bend, double white line.
He has to work fast and hope the traffic doesn't spook the little pony.
Hello, Lockie. Now, Lock, we got no buggering around getting across this road, mate. Don't you push me in front of a car.
Les is trying to get this miniature pony across a busy road. On a blind corner, with speeding traffic. And a horse that could get halfway across and then decide to stop.
I'll bring him over to you, mate.
Timing his run will be critical.
Good on you, buddy. See you all, mate. Take care. See you, bud. I guess the size he was, I probably could have picked him up and put him under my arm and run across the road with him.
Next overnight stop, stables in Townsville. For Les, this is where it all began.
That little old block of stables you can see right there. Just there, that's where we lived when I was a kid. Yeah, my dad trained racehorse and I was only a little tiny fella on my goat cart and I come up the middle of them stable block one day and a big old stallion. Racehorse he had his head over the stable door and he picked me up out of the goat cart and nearly scalped me, he did. About 3-year-old, I think, yeah.
Not the best memory to have when you're about to go another round with Grumpy Jerry.
Right, we old fella, we now. We. Come on, old man. That bug-eyed look out of you. Ooh, put him outside. He'd be happier outside this old fella than locked up in a stable. I told you he'd love me by the end of the trip. Ooh, old fella. He's very antisocial.
Next morning, it's up before the sun. With 900 kilometres to travel. Grumpy Jerry meets his new owners today, but he's not in a great mood.
I think he don't like early mornings. Other than not liking people, I think he hates early starts because he snorted and farted and blew snot at me. And I thought, hello, we're back to square one.
So far, every drop-off has gone without a hitch, but Les has been around long enough to know that can change in an instant. The next delivery could be just as scary. That will be his old mate Jerry, and Les hopes that last horse hasn't given him any ideas.
There's normally one mongrel or, you know, one that's going to give you a bit of a hard time, but now we got my old mate Friendly Jerry, the grumpy horse, he's the next drop off to his new owner, so that's going to be a ball of joy for them. And yeah, we'll see how the lovely lady goes giving old Jerry a cuddle. G'day.
Jerry's owner has waited weeks for this moment.
I didn't sleep last night, I was so excited.
We've come to the end of the journey for old grumpy Jerry.
Les is hoping it's a fond farewell.
I hope he minds his manners and is nice and civil to his new owner. You've just become me old mate, haven't you? Whoa. Alrighty, Jerry. Come on, me old mate. He's so odd. I actually love him.
I actually love him.
He's been
great. Thank you.
For Grumpy Jerry, it's grumpy no more. A new home, new owners, and new adventures ahead. For Les, it's another successful delivery in one of the toughest jobs there is.
Old Grumpy Jerry, he got to where he had to go and never hurt me or anyone else, so no harm was done by old Jerry.